Hello friends, welcome to CrackGate CSC, and in this series of database we have covered nested queries first part in the previous video. So we have discussed what is independent nested queries in the previous video, and in this video we will be discussing about the correlated nested queries. So before starting, I would like to request you all, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it and press the notification icon for the notification whenever I am uploading a new video. So let's start with this second part of the nested queries, which is correlated nested queries. So see, the inner query uses the attribute of outer query from class. So what's the meaning of correlated nested query? That there has to be some relation between these two subqueries. If you are having two subquery in a particular SQL query, then those two subquery need to have some relation between these two. This is what is written here, that the inner query uses the attribute of outer query from class. So it will be taking some attribute from the from class of outer query. Second thing is, it is allowed in where and having clause of the outer query. What does this mean? It means that whenever we are using the correlated nested queries, it can be written with where clause and with having clause. If we know that in where clause and having clause we have some conditions, so on the place of those conditions we can write these particular correlated nested query. Now let's try to understand this with help of some example. So see, I'm having here an example where R and S are two table or a relation with A and B attribute, and this is the query written: select A from R where. So these correlated nested query can be used in two ways, that means in where and having clause. So first of all, I am discussing about the where clause conditions, where clause queries, and in the next few seconds we'll be discussing about the having correlated nested queries. So see, we have to select A from relation R where. So instead of where, here with where I am using a particular condition, that means select count. Select A from R where it needs to satisfy this particular condition, where this will give some output, this subquery will give some output, and it has to be checked with it whether it is greater than 2 or not. So how we can do that? See, first of all, check this thing, that the inner query, which is this one, is using the attribute of the outer query. So R dot A, see, this R dot A is the attribute of the outer query which has been used in the inner query. So this is a correlated nested query. Got that? Now the correlated nested query will be executed for each respective row. That means for 10 also it needs to be executed, for 20 also it needs to be executed. So it will not be executed once. In independent nested query, the inner query gets executed only one time, but here it will be executed by the number of records. So if you are having 10 records, like we are having 5 records here, so it needs to be executed 5 times. So number of records in the outer query will lead that how many times the inner query needs to be executed or computed. Now let's see what will be the output of this particular query. So first of all, select A from R. So first of all, we need to go with this particular value, because for each row it needs to be computed multiple times. So select count star from S, where R dot A. R dot A means this 10 value. R dot A is less than S dot B. So we need to find out that how many values of SB are greater than R dot A. How we can do that? See, 10 is greater than 15, 10 is greater than 25, 10 is greater than 35, and 10 is greater than, sorry, I think I did something wrong over here. Let me check. It was said R dot A has to be less than S dot B. Okay, right. So see, R dot A, 10 is less than 15, less than 25, less than 35, less than 45. That means the 10 is less than 4. So output for A is 4. Now we have to check this condition, whether 4 is greater than 2? Yes, this condition is satisfied. That means one output will be 10. Similarly, now we have to check for next value of A. So the next value of A is 20. Now we have to make sure that 20. We have to count that how the 20 is less than how many values of SB. So 20 is less than 25, 35 and 45. So this is for 10. Now 20, we are getting 3 by executing this, because 3 values are greater than 20. 3 values of SB are greater than 20. So 3 is greater than 2, because we have to check this condition again. So it has been satisfied. So again I got one output as 20. Now we have to check for this 30. So 30 is less than 35 and 45. That means 2. So whether 2 is greater than 2? No. So this cannot be included in answer. Similarly, we have to check 40. 40 is less than 45 only. That means 1 is not greater than 2. This can also not be in the solution. Similarly, 50. 50 is not greater than any. That means 0. Not greater than 2. That means the output for this particular query will be 10 to 20. So this will be the output of this particular query. So I hope you got an idea how exactly this is going on. Now let's try to understand this with another example. Here I am having this particular table and this query. So what we have to do here is we have to select A from RT1. RT1 means I am renaming our table R as T1. And in the inner query you can see that I am renaming R table as T2. That means I am taking two copies of the same table. One has been renamed with T as T1 and other has been renamed as T2. So here I am having 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So these are the same table. So see, now if you find out, we have to find that T1A is less than T2A. That means how many values of A in T1 is less than T2.A. So if you check for this 10, if you check for this 10, this will give you the value as C. So 10 is less than T2.A. So how many values can be there? C. 10 is less than 20, 30, 40, 50 and 60 also. So 10 is less than 5 values of T2 also, because we have to find out the number of records which satisfies these conditions. So 10 is less than 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. That means 5. Now we have to make sure that 5 is less than 3. No, 5 is not less than 3. That means 10 cannot be in the output. Similarly for 20. 20 is less than 1, 2, 3, 4, 4. So we have to check 4 less than 3. No. Similarly for 30. 30 is less than these 3. So how many records? 3 records. Failed. If you check for this 40. So 40 is less than 50 and 60. That means 2. And 2 is less than 3. Yes. Satisfied. Similarly 50. 50 is less than only 1 record. And 1 is less than 3. This condition is also satisfied. And 60, which is 0 less than 3, is also satisfied. So what will be the output? 40, 50 and 60 will be the output, because only these 3 values are satisfying this particular condition. So this is how we can find out the output. Now there is a question. See, I am having a particular table student with SID as mark with their respective details, and here I need to find out the student ID from student as T1. So I am taking, because I am relating with the same table, so I am taking a copy of this and renaming it as T1, where select count distinct T2 dot marks from student as T2. So I am taking another table as T2. So this as is used to rename the table name or the attribute name. Student has been renamed as T2, student has been renamed as T1. So this as operator or this as clause can be used to rename the table name or the attribute name. You can also rename this SID as ID. So this is one important clause that can be used with the SQL query. Now see, We have to find out distinct T2 marks from student as T2 where T1 dot marks is greater than T2 dot marks. So we have to find the number of rows. So for example, let's talk about the 90 because we have to execute it row by row in where condition. In where we are not having any group or something, so we have to execute it for each row. So for this 90, so 90 is 90 greater than how many of T2 dot marks? So see, if I check in T2, so 90 is greater than this 80, 70 and 60. These three distinct values. So 90 is greater than these three distinct values because we are just counting the distinct values. So we cannot count this 80 once again. So we got 3 as an output of this particular inner query. So 3 is output for this particular query. Whether 3 is equal to 1? No. So 3 is not equal to 1. So it cannot be in the answer. Similarly, check for 80. So for first row, we have computed the inner query once. For 80, we have to compute it again. So 80 is greater than how many? 80 is greater than 70 and 60. That means 2. So 2 is equals to 1? No. This also fails the condition. So this is also done. We already checked for this 90, so we are not checking it again. Now come to 70. Now check whether this 70 is greater than how many of the values. So 70 is greater than only one value, that is 60. So that means it is greater than only one value of T2. So 1 is equals to 1. Yes, it satisfies the condition. 60, it is not greater than any of the values. 90 we have already checked here. 80 we have already checked here. So the only output for this particular table will be S4. So the only output is S4 because S4 is the only SID which is having some marks which are greater than some marks of T2 table which is equal to 1. So this will be in output because we have to retrieve the student ID from student table whose marks are greater than some T2 marks by only 1. So here you can see one thing is that it is giving you the second minimum value. It is giving you the second minimum. You can see that this is nothing but the second minimum. 70 is the second minimum marks in the student table. But what if you have to check for the first minimum? So for first minimum, if there is any question in gate in which he is asking for the first minimum, how you can use that? So query will be like this only. You have to change the attributes accordingly. What will be the condition? The condition has to be greater than equal to with condition as equal to 0. So here I am having equal to 1. That's why it is giving you the second minimum value. One is giving the second minimum. So if it is 0 with this greater sign, it will give you the first minimum. It will give you the first minimum value. Similarly, for second minimum, if they ask you to find the second minimum, we have to use the greater than sign and the condition has to be equal to 1, like in this particular example. So it will give you the second minimum. You can check the particular example. So 70 is the second minimum value of the marks. What if we have to find out the highest value? So if we want to find out the highest value, what we have to do? For highest value, we have to change this operator as less than equal to, and condition will be if equal to 0, then it will give you the highest value. So if you use this particular operator with this condition over here, try to execute by changing these signs, you will got to know that it will give you the highest value. It will give you 90, that means S1 as output. So this is how you can find out the highest value. And if they are asking you for the second highest or second maximum, then the condition of if will be changing to is equal to 1. So similarly, we can change these values 1, 2, 3. So if they are asking you to find the nth maximum value, then the condition has to be less than, if equal to has to be n minus 1. Similarly, if they are asking for the minimum value, this particular sign will change and this will remain as same. So this is how you can find out the values, find out the highest values, minimum value, second minimum, third minimum, and so on. So this is very important question which can come in your exam. Now let's try to understand this correlated nested queries in the having clause. So we are about to do the having clause. So see, here I am having an example, that is select department number from employee as T1, group by department number, having average salary, select average salary from this particular series. So here you can see that in having, I am having a particular condition, and in that condition I am using the particular query. So how we can do that? See, first of all, let's try to understand that what is the statement, what this particular query is trying to do. So see, it is retrieving the department number. It is retrieving the department number for which the average salary of employees is more than the average salary of male employees of same department. What is the inner query? Now let's try to understand that how I am able to form this particular statement. See, this is trying to find out the average salary of, see, gender is male, average salary of male employee, and here we are talking about the same department, that means average salary of male employee of same department, right? Now see, here we are retrieving the department number for which the average salary of employee is greater than this particular statement. So how I can write it? I can write it like this: retrieve the department number for which average salary of employee is greater than average salary of male employee of same department. So this is how you can find out the statement. So always try to analyze the inner query first. On the basis of inner query, we got to know how the outer query is responding. So now let's try to find out the value of the output. How we can find out the output? See, for this particular query, I'm having this particular table. So we are having an employee table. So in the outer query, we are renaming it as T1, which I did over here. And in the inner query, I'm renaming it as T2, which I did over here. So I got these particular tables. Now we have to find out each group by group, because in group by, in where clause, what we were doing, we was checking the condition for each particular record, each particular row. But here we will check the condition for each particular department, right? So first of all, we are here it was select the department number from employee as T1, group by department number, having average salary. So let's talk about the average salary for this first table. So let's try with the department number 1. So department number 1, what is the average salary of department number 1? See, this is department number 1, this is department number 1. So this 90 plus 80 divided by 2. So the average salary, and it is the department number. So this is one group, which is 1.85. So for one group, so we have grouping it by department number. So we grouped it by department number, and the average salary is 85. Now we have to make sure that this 85 has to be greater than the average salary of T2 table, where gender is male and department is same. So first of all, I have to check for the department, where the department is same. Here the department is same, and here the department is same. So what is the second condition? Gender has to be male. Here the gender has to be male, and here the gender is female. So we will not take this in the consideration. So what is the average salary of this particular? See, here only one record and the average salary is 90, because 90 divided by 1, so here it is 90 for 1. So you can see that 85 is greater than 90, no, so it cannot be in the output. See, for every group we are getting only one value from here, that is average, right? Now similarly we have to talk about the second department. So for second department, you can see that this is second, and find out the average, it will be 60. Similarly, go with the second here. Here I have second, here I am saying second. Here it is male, here it is female. So we will not take the record where the female is there, so because we are not comparing with female. So what will be the average? There is one, only one record, so the average is 70. So is 60 greater than 70? Is 60 greater than 70? No, so it cannot be in record. Similarly, for the third. So here you can see that for third, the average is 45, because this is 30, this is 60, and 90 by 2 is 45. Now check here. For 3, I am having 2 records, and in both, I am having gender as male. So what is the average? 60 plus 30 divided by 2 is 45. So 45 is greater than 45? No, so this cannot be in the record. Similarly, for 4th. So what is the average for 4th? See, 4th, 50 and 80. So what is the average? 65. 50 plus 80 by 2, that is 65. So check here for the 4th. So this is 4th record, this is 4th department record, and this is 4th department record. Here this female gender has to be striked out. Now what will be the average? 50 is the average. So is it greater than? Yes. So what will be the output? The output will be the department number 4, because department number 4 is, see here, this department number 4 is the department which is having the average salary of the employee greater than the average salary of male employee of same department. This is how we can find it out for group. So here you can see that I find out it for each group, for department 1 group, department 2 group, 3 and 4. So how many the number of groups decide that how many times the error query has to be executed. Now let's try to understand this another example. See, in this example we have to select employee ID from employee where salary, we are having a comparison is equal to select salary from employee where department number is equals to 4. So see, if I check here for department is equal to 4, I will be getting two values. How? We have to select the salary for department number 4. So this is one record of department number 4, and this is another record of department number 4. And what is the salary? 50 and 80. The inner query is returning 50 and 80, two values. If it is returning two values, we cannot compare one value with these two values, because here we are having a particular value in salary. For example, if I start from first row, it will be 90. So 90 equal to a set of value, it's not right way, because we have to compare value with value, not value with set of values. So this particular kind of query will give you error, because here for comparison so there is a rule, we can say that for comparison inner query must give single value. So inner query must give the single value, not set of value, right? So here it is giving set of values. This is why this will give you an error. So this is not the right way to use the correlated nested query in where clause. So I hope you got an idea how exactly things are going on. So this is a kind of difficult topic, you can say, because there is a relation between the inner query and the outer query. So if you are having any doubt related to this particular chapter or this particular video, you can just message me, or you can comment in the comment box, or you can also message or post your query in my Facebook page or group. I will give you the link in the description. So if you are not clear about this particular video, just watch it once again. You will be getting a clear idea how the things are working.
So if you find this video useful, like this video, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you are new over here. So thank you for watching. Keep supporting, keep learning. Have a great day.